And China has achieved a lot in the last 70 years, especially in the last few decades when China opened up to the rest of the world by inviting investors from different parts of the world who invested heavily in the Chinese economy, and also by getting Chinese people to work hard to improve their own lives and the lives of their citizens by providing health, education, clean water, housing, among many other things. This China has been able to achieve, and I must pay tribute to the Chinese leaders for their foresight, and also to the Chinese people for the hard work which they put into building the new China that we see today. I hope that African countries can learn from what the Chinese people have been able to do in the last 70 years. Development is a continuous process. It never ends, it merely begins. The relationship between Africa and China is based on mutual respect and non-interference in the internal affairs of each other going forward. This is a relationship which is based on common values, common principles and common values, because at the end of the day, we have to respect each other as we continue to deal with each other both at the political and economic levels. It's a much more realistic relationship for Africa and China to have, and for China and Africa to have. And it is a relationship which has been able to withstand the test of time, because non-interference in each other's internal affairs is important. It's an important principle to observe.